Hello guys, today we are going to make a logo, 3D logo from a 2D image. So I am going to tell you what type of image it is that we need and how do we do that. So first of all, we need an SVG image, SVG type of the image. Like we have PNGs, we have JPEGs and stuff like that. Same like that, we have SVGs. So it is like it's not possible easily to find SVGs of any logo. So what we do is we download a PNG image of a logo. Like I downloaded a PNG image of Adidas. So I searched on the Google that convert PNG into SVG. So it will give you a link. The very first link on the page, on the first page, you will open it up and it will ask you to upload the file. So when you upload the file, it will convert it. You will press start conversion and it will convert the file and you will get a SVG file. It will download it. It takes the next page and you will click the download and it will download the SVG file. So now we have SVG files and we have Blender already. So what we do now is we go to file, we go to import and then we go SVG, scalable vector graphic. So we click on that. Now my SVG file is in downloads, so I will go there, read this like there. I will open it up, import SVG. Yeah, so there you can see my Adidas logo is right there. Okay, so now they are different objects, so I need to, and it is not an object right now, it is just something like, you know, a curve or something like that. So if you go into edit mode, it is not an object right now, so you need to convert this into an object. So I will select all of these, press A to select all. Now convert to. Now we go into object, there is an object tab, we go in there, object tab. So press A to select all of these, go into object, convert to mesh from the curve, mesh, surface or text. So we will convert it into mesh. So now I think it is converted into mesh, I think. So let's add a solidify modifier. There you can see there's the modifier. Okay, so now we have to apply the modifier to all of these. I normally assign the shortcut keys to the modifiers I use most, like solidify modifier and boolean array, like that, you know, wireframe. It's simple, you know, it's simple stuff like that you can do. Just assign some shortcut to your modifiers to make the work easier and a lot more quicker. So like that you can assign modifier by right clicking on the modifier you want to assign shortcut. I usually do E with solidify modifier. From the beginning I have kept E for the solidify modifier, so I will press E. So when I press E, you will see it will add. So there you go, now we have two. Now this and this. Okay, we have applied modifier to all of these objects. Now what we have to do is we have to go into shading tab and remove this material because we don't want this material there. We have our own material or something like that, so we will remove this material, of course. And okay, so we need to remove this. Okay, so there is no material on that now. So we are material free right now. I'll go back into my scene. this is what we get. So now now you want to apply the certify modifier effect. So what we do is we apply at them, so we have applied the modifier to all of them. If not applied, you will see something here like that. Okay, let me give you an example. Yeah, okay, so we have an array, like I have selected this one and there is no nothing in here. So if I select all of these, there's still nothing in there. It should be there, so I'll just cancel it. Okay, so now what we have to do is we have to convert this into one object. So we press Control J is for join. We will join all these. No, they are one. You can grab it, take it anywhere, set a region to geometry to region. So geometry is on a region. Now we will import a plane to make our logo look good. We will go into shading. We will assign our logo a black color, just like Adidas. And there's our logo. You can adjust the shine and all you want. It totally depends on you. What you like, what you don't. That's all depending on you. Okay, so there's our logo. You can add some shine or you can remove. You can add, you can remove whatever you want. That's up to you. I'll make some 0.2 of metallic. Okay, 0.2 of metallic and 0.4 of roughness. That's good. Great. Okay. So I'll go into that. There you go, there's the logo, our Adidas, okay, G on Z axis, okay, so that's done. Now we can do lighting if you want to. The logo is done, you can just export it, it would be alright. There's your logo of Adidas. You can make it in very little time, like 5 minutes. So I hope you like it. So please subscribe the channel to have more videos and give a like to this video.